Riley, are you ready to start your wedding ceremony? I would like to warmly welcome you all to Stormont Hotel and to this very important and special occasion for Ian and Kelly. It is good to see you all here today to join in their celebrations, but you will also be taking part in today's ceremony by listening to and witnessing the two legal declarations that must be made by Ian and Kelly. You will begin by declaring that you are legally free to be married to one another, and then at the moment of the marriage itself, you will make a marriage contract with one another, taking each other to be husband and wife. I am Patricia Monaghan, a Deputy Registrar of Marriages for the District of Belfast, and as such, I am empowered to conduct civil marriages in this place in which we are now met. You, Ian Quinn, and you, Kelly Ann Brown, are now about to marry each other. In accordance with the law, in my presence, and in the presence of your witnesses, Ian and Kelly, before you are joined in matrimony, I have to remind you of the solemn and binding character of the contract you are about to make. Marriage, according to the law of this country, is the union of two people, voluntarily entered into, to the exclusion of all others. Ian and Kelly, are you ready to take your vows? Please repeat after me. I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare.
That I know not.
That I know not.
Of any lawful. Of any.
of any lawful.
Impediment. Why I, Ian Quinn.
Why I, Ian Quinn.
May not be joined.
May not be joined.
In matrimony.
In matrimony.
To Kellyanne Brown.
To Kellyanne Brown.
I call upon
these persons here present
to witness
that I, Ian Quinn,
do take you, Kelly Brown,
to be my lawful wedded wife.
Kelly, please repeat after me. I do solemnly declare
that I know not
of any
Why I, Kelly Brown,
may not
be joined
in matrimony
to Ian Quinn.
I call upon
these persons
here present
to witness
that I, Kelly Brown,
do take you, Ian Quinn,
be my lawful wedded husband. Now, Ian and Kelly have chosen an extra vow, and I'm going to ask it of each of you in turn. Ian, will you solemnly promise that you will always protect Kelly with your utmost care, that you will honour and cherish her in sickness and in health, for richer or poorer, and that in all things you will be to Kelly a faithful and loving husband?
I will.
Kelly, will you solemnly promise that you will always protect Ian with your utmost care, that you will honour and cherish him in sickness and in health, for richer or poorer, and that in all things you will be to Ian a faithful and loving wife? We now have the exchange of rings. Kelly, if you'd like to put the bouquet on the table. And Ian, you're going to place Kelly's ring on first. There's two rings. She's got two rings, that's why.
There's a money's worth.
So Ian's
piece of paper on the wrong finger.
Hello. That was a deliberate mistake. Well
done. Ian, as you place the rings, repeat after me. Kelly, I give you these rings. As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
And of our marriage today.
And of our marriage today.
It's just having mom, right?
So I could afford.
Please bring on Ian's finger and paint after me. Ian, I give you this ring. As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
And of our marriage today.
And of our marriage today.
Ian Kelly, as a token of the contract into which you have entered, these rings are given and the same. Today you have pledged your commitment to each other. May you always begin each day with fresh hope in your hearts. May you have happiness by being happy with one another, and may you find love in loving one another. By virtue of the covenants made in my presence as a deputy registrar of marriages and before your witnesses, I have great pleasure in declaring that you, Ian Quinn, and you, Kellyanne Brown, are now joined together in matrimony in accordance with the law. May be the first to congratulate and kiss the bride.
It's for the only one I see.